Hi, I'm Phil Blackson on the Big BB, Blackson and Basie. Today we're interviewing Jessica Moose about the attack in the Canadian woods. Also we're interviewing Brian Robeson. Hi Brian, how are you?
Good. You?
Well, when and where was the attack?
Well, it was by the L-shaped lake in the Canadian woods. I'm not quite sure of the date though, but it was around the 46th day I was there.
What exactly happened during the attack?
Well, I killed a full bird for lunch and I watched.
Sorry to interrupt, but what's a full bird?
A full bird? Well, a full bird, I'm not quite sure, but I call it a full bird because it's shaped like a big pear and it tastes like chicken.
Thanks, go on.
Where was I? Oh yeah. I killed the full bird for lunch and I was washing the blood off my hands when a heavy wind was behind me. I turned around and wham, the moose hit me. And then I wasn't quite sure what happened on the rest because of the pain.
How did you react to the hit?
Well, I couldn't really react because of the pain, but I sort of punched the moose lightly.
Where were you hit?
I was hit in the ribs.
Right here?
Yeah.
Your whole rib cage?
I'm pretty sure.
Well, that must have really hurt. Did you break any bones?
I think so, yeah. Mm.
Did you threaten the moose in any way to make it attack you?
I'm not quite sure, but maybe the moose attacked me because of the blood on my hands and my bow and arrow.
Thanks for coming here today, Brian. Now we have Logan Basie interviewing Jessica Moose, the moose who attacked Brian.
Thanks, Phil. I'm Logan Basie interviewing Jessica Moose in the Canadian woods. Hello, Jessica. How are you today?
Fine. How about you?
Good. So, why did you attack Brian?
Brian? Who's Brian? I attacked a black panther, not this Brian you speak of.
Brian isn't a black panther. He's a human.
Oh, I must have been going through one of my delusional periods. I'm getting more of those since my eyesight's getting worse.
So, how many times did you hit this black panther?
Oh, I must have hit him about 3 times.
Okay. So, even though Brian was a black panther, why did you attack him?
Well, black panthers run like the wind, and they have a knack for eating young ones like Carol.
Carol? Who's Carol?
Carol's my young calf. She turned 2 weeks just yesterday.
So the only reason you attacked was to protect Carol?
Yeah, Carol, myself, and the whole forest.
The whole forest? How so?
Well, black panthers aren't that common here in the Canadian woods. I think that was the only one I saw in my whole life. So, if he gets too comfortable here, he might attack all my friends, family, and neighbors. Plus myself.
Okay. Thank you for coming today, Jessica.
What do I do with it?
You shake it.
Oh, okay.
Phil, I think this attack was a complete misunderstanding. Jessica attacked out of protection, not out of rage or madness.
Yes, I agree, but still, I think Jessica's ears are tranquilized in the butt. Oh well. Thanks for watching the Big BB.
Good morning, New York. I'm your host, Rachel Jackson, and today I will be interviewing 13-year-old Brian Robeson on a moose attack. Hello, Brian. How are you?
Good, thanks.
So, where did the event take place?
Well, it happened right near the L-shaped lake where I live.
And what exactly did happen?
Well, I was just minding my own business down by the lake when something in the back of my head told me something wasn't right. Just as I turned around, I saw this moose charging full force at me.
Do you know if it was a female moose or a male moose?
I was lucky. It was a female moose. If it was a male moose, it would have torn me apart with its antlers.
What did she do to you?
Well, just as I turned around, using her neck, she flung me into the lake and then came in after me. She pounded me into the mud with her hooves.
Do you think you did anything to offend her?
I don't think so. I was just washing my hands.
And after that, did she let you go or keep pounding you into the water?
Oh no, she wasn't done yet. Every time I tried to move, she just did it again.
Do you think she was trying to kill you or just warn you?
She was a big one. I think she could have killed me if she wanted to. So she was probably just trying to warn me.
And how did you get away?
It wasn't easy, let me tell you that. Like I said, every time I tried to move, she just did it again. So I had to move really slowly all the way to shore so she wouldn't get scared.
How badly were you hurt? I mean, you really made it sound like she hit you hard.
My ribs were hurt really bad. It was really hard to breathe, so I think she broke a few of them. I was sore all over. I had to, so sore, I had to crawl back to my shelter.
That must have taken a lot of effort. Why do you think she attacked you?
I don't know, that's a hard one. Maybe she had never seen a human before. I would be scared too.
Did you have anything that could threaten her?
Come to think of it, I did have my bow and arrow, and my spear, and my hatchet by the lake.
What do you use these things for?
I use them for hunting.
And what were you doing before the incident occurred?
Well, I had just caught a fool bird for my lunch and was washing it off by the lake when the moose attacked me.
What exactly is a fool bird?
A fool bird is a really dumb bird in the shape of a pear. It's hard to see because it camouflages really well.
I don't think I've ever heard of that bird before. Well, that's all the time we have, so thank you for coming on Good Morning New York. And now, here's Nikki Muller interviewing Miss Madam Mary Moose. Over to you, Nikki.
Thank you, Rachel. With me today, we have Miss Madam Mary Moose. She is going to tell us her side of the story. My first question is, what exactly happened?
Well, I've been seeing this boy around the woods, and he's been killing my friends and companions. I decided to get revenge because just thinking about it made me mad. Using my neck, I flung him into the lake. Then I followed him in. I rammed him in the ribs and into the mud, along with his head. I did this 3 times to give him a taste of his own medicine.
Did he offend you in any way?
He did. Like I said before, he's been killing everybody in this community. It's very hard to see.
Is that why you attacked him?
Partly. I also attacked him because he was carrying many weapons.
Did you ever have any encounters with humans before?
Yes. A while ago, my husband and I were walking towards a berry bush to get some berries for my son, Mikey. We were almost there when a strange arrow-like thing hit my husband in the back.
What happened to your husband?
Well, he fell to the floor with a thud. I knew the humans must have done this, but I had hope and I thought he must have not died. So, gathering all the strength in my body, I tried pulling him home, but I only got as far as behind a clump of trees. I had to go home.
Why did you go home?
To get some help to carry my husband back home.
Did he react? How did he react when you hit him?
Well, he didn't do anything major because he was too shocked, but he whipped his face around and I saw a surprised but scared look on his face.
Did he threaten you in any way?
As I mentioned before, he was carrying many weapons, and I thought he would kill me or at least hurt me. He was carrying a bow and arrow and a 2-pronged spear.
Thank you, Miss Madam Mary Moose.
You're very welcome.
See you next time on Good Morning New York.
Hello, I'm Nick White. Today in Hampton Studios, we are going to interview Brian Robeson, age 13, about yesterday's moose attack. So, Brian, at around what time did the moose attack you?
It was around noontime yesterday on the banks of the L-shaped lake.
So, what did she do to attack?
Well, she just camped behind me and then slammed me into the water.
So how did you survive this ambush? This moose must have been as heavy as a boulder.
Luckily, I was able to escape from her grasp and crawl back to my cave.
Well, what do you mean by crawled? How could you have crawled away?
Well, I had to crawl because every time I made a sudden movement, she would charge at me again.
Ooh. Why do you think the moose attacked you? I mean, she couldn't have attacked you for no reason.
Maybe she was spooked by the dead fool bird in my hands, the weapons on my belt, or maybe I was just in her territory.
Then why did you go in her territory?
Maybe, are there no signs or anything, no tracks? How was I supposed to know?
Okay, what injuries did you suffer from this incident?
Well, there's this gash on my shoulder, and there's this fairly large hurts, and a few bruises on my shoulder and chest.
Okay, do you think it was right for the moose to attack you?
No, I was just bending down, cleaning off the blood from the fool bird, and then she just camped behind me and charged for no reason.
Okay, so what's a fool bird?
A fool bird is a pear-shaped turkey thing, a bird that I named it a fool bird because it's not very bright.
Okay, thank you, Brian, for taking the time to talk with us tonight.
You're welcome.
So now we are going to hear the other side of the story with Mika White, who is going to interview the moose herself.
Hello, today we are here in the Canadian woods to interview Miss Moose about yesterday's occurrence. Miss Moose, the obvious question, the first question that just pops into your mind, why did you attack this innocent-looking boy, Brian?
Well, I was just eating my daily lunch when this thing with blood all over his hands walked into my territory. And I saw the weapons beside him and thought he could harm me with them somehow.
Oh, so basically you're just trying to protect yourself overall, right?
Yes, me and the rest of the forest.
So, did you have the right to attack Brent? Like, were you allowed to attack him?
Yes, it happened quite near my home.
Well, how hard did you attack him? Like, not hard or soft, but, well, how hard did you attack him?
Well, I know I didn't hit him that hard, because if I did, I would have broken his back, which I didn't.
But he's just a boy. He's small, he's skinny, he's just a 13-year-old boy lost in this island or wherever it was.
I didn't know he was a boy because none of them ever come by. And I didn't know I could hurt him that hard. I'm a female moose.
But you rammed him 3 times.
Who's doing the damage? It was my, I have small horns. They weren't the ones doing the damage. It was my hooves.
Hooves or horns, no matter. But did you at least feel any pity at all while ramming him?
No, it serves him right. He should have known.
Was he threatening you in any way to make him make another reason to attack him?
In a way, because he was holding my dead friend Cookie in his hand. And I saw the weapons beside him, like I mentioned earlier, and he could have easily picked up and kill me with them. And he was walking on my land.
Well, there might have been a reason that he walked on your land, but was there any proof or evidence that tells us that he was on your land?
Yes, I made hoof marks all around my home. I didn't put them there for no reason. Yes. People these days need to look out more.
Yes, but the victim claims that he didn't see any hoof marks.
Well, that's his problem. He probably didn't look down at the right place.
Okay, well, thank you for your time, Miss Moose. I learned a lot more on this event. I'm Mika White. Thank you for watching.
Hi.
Welcome to the NSCS Network.
This is Natalie Satterfield
and Christine Swenson.
Today we are here to interview 13-year-old Brian Robeson,
Miss Margaret Moose, and Mr. Bubba Bear. Now to Natalie.
Thank you, Christine. I'll now be interviewing Brian Robeson, who was recently attacked by Miss Margaret Moose. Hello, Brian. How are you feeling today?
Fine, thank you.
I've heard about the moose attack incident. What was the moose doing before the attack?
Well, I saw the moose eating some lily pads.
How hard did the moose hit you?
The moose hit me harder than ever, in the ribs.
Wow, that must have really hurt. So, will you describe what really happened?
Well, I was washing my hands when I saw a moose rushing towards me, then wham, she hit me.
What were you washing off your hands?
I just killed a fool bird, and I was washing its blood off.
You mentioned a fool bird. What exactly is a fool bird?
A fool bird is a small red bird that's shaped like a pear.
Well, I've never heard of those kinds of birds before, so I find that very interesting. But how did you manage to get away from the moose?
After each time she hit me, I tried to crawl to my hut. But then she found me again and hit me again. But after the third time, she ignored me.
Well, that was very interesting. Thank you for coming here and giving us this information. Now over to Christine Swenson in the Canadian wilderness.
Thanks, Natalie. Hi, this is Christine Swenson reporting from the Canadian wilderness, where earlier Brian Robeson was attacked by Miss Margaret Moose. So, Miss Moose, why did you attack Brian?
I did not attack Brian. All I was doing was trying to play with him.
What made you want to play with him?
Well, he looked really lonely. My friends told me that humans were dangerous, but I don't believe them.
Your friends say humans are dangerous, which most animals say they would be. What makes you say they're not?
Well, one time my sister was down here too, and she saw a human here too, and the human started to play with her and pet her and feed her, and when she told me then I believed that they were good.
In detail, will you explain to me exactly what happened that the lake 2 hours ago?
Well, I was down at the lake eating my lily pad when I saw a human boy emerge from and wash his hands, and he looked really lonely, so I went over to him and nudged him into the lake. I guess he didn't feel like playing with me because he hit me on the forehead. I got mad at him for doing this, so I pushed him into the lake, this time harder. I did that 2 times, and then I got tired, so I went back to eating my lily pad. A little later, I saw Brian crawling back to his shelter, and he was making these weird noises that made my fur go up and down.
So let me get it straight. You were eating your lily pad, and you saw Brian sitting there alone. So you went over to go nudge him in the lake to play?
Yeah.
And he didn't feel like playing, so he started banging you on the head?
Yeah.
You didn't like it, so you did the same 2 more times, but harder? And then you got tired and walked away, mm-hmm. and so did he.
Mm-hmm.
And 2 hours ago, Brian, you had rammed into Brian into the lake. And earlier on the show, Brian said that when you did this, you had broken some of his ribs. Do you have any effect on this?
No, definitely not. When I rammed him into the lake, he didn't look hurt. And also, it was only a little nudge.
Well, thank you for your time, Miss Moose.
My pleasure.
Now, Mr. Bubba Bear, who is an eyewitness at the scene of the attack, will share his side of the story. Good evening, Mr. Bubba Bear.
Thank you. Good afternoon. Good evening to you, too.
Where and what were you doing at the scene of the attack?
I was eating berries at my favorite berry bush, like I do every day.
What did you see at the lake?
Well, I heard a loud splash, and as I looked up, I saw Margaret ramming into Brian.
Why do you think Miss Moose rammed into Brian?
Well, I don't really know, but my guess is that she got scared because Brian had weapons with him.
When you saw this, did you want to help Brian in any way?
Yeah. I ran to my friend Goosey Lucy's house, but when I turned around, Brian was crawling back to his cave, that shelter. I was too late.
So you didn't make it in time?
No.
Well, thank you for joining us this evening.
You're welcome. Anytime.
Join us next time when Bill Nye explains how he thinks Mount St. Helens will erupt again. This has been Christine Swenson and Natalie Satterfield. Have a nice evening.